please welcome to the stage your president and CEO, Chris Cicchinelli.
Open up the champagne, pop. It's my house, come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. 'Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you been. Pour yourself something cold, baby, cheers to this. Sometimes you gotta stay in.
You know, are you guys ready for tonight? I'm telling you, look at this room. I'm telling you, filled to white. We are looking good. We're ready for a little bit of South Beach in our life. Everybody went and got their nails done, toes did, spray tans on. That's kind of how it goes, man. We are going to have a fun, fun night. And I can tell you right now, that's the exciting part about this. Tonight and over the next couple days, this is what you've saved for. This is what you put away for. You put it in your wine bottles. How many people put some money in their wine bottles? Crack that damn thing open and is ready to spend some money and making it a fun, exciting trip for them to come here and get some education, to get some knowledge, and take it back and really rock out their businesses. That's what you're here for? What about Patty's speech? What about that woman? I always say, and I tell her, I'm always like, you know, I have to tell you this each and every time I come back from the road. I appreciate the opportunity that you've been able to give our family, but I'm more proud of the opportunity of the thousands of families that you've been able to go out there and help. And that's the important thing. And today I got a lot of people that I want to thank. I want to thank all of those ladies today that were President's Club board members that helped out with registration. Please stand up. I want to give them a big, huge round of applause. They did an awesome, awesome job. And where is, I don't know, but do we have any first-time attendees here at Pure Romance? I think the first-time attendees are here. And I also got to welcome, it's been a crazy couple years here at Pure Romance. It's been crazy, but been fun all at the same time. If you think about it right now, in 2014, we welcomed an unbelievable group of women that came and joined our Pure Romance family. And you know what? They came on, and it has been a magical union of a lot of strong individuals that have helped propel this company to where we need to go. And this year, we had another group of individuals that we've been able to welcome in to our Pure Romance family. It's amazing as you see some of these ladies walking through, and I want to welcome them because I can tell you right now, just like being a first-time attendee and just by coming to your first convention, there's so much that's going to go on this week. But I got to tell you this, I couldn't be more proud of a group of women that have come over and they hit the ground running and said, you know what, this isn't a pink thing, it's not a purple thing, it's not a product thing, it's not an executive thing, it's not a Tom thing, it's not a coochie thing, it's not even a just like me thing, it's a damn green thing, it's called money. And that's what it's about. Because like Mom said, you own your own spotlight. Your customers party with you. They're excited about every time they see you. Because you are the starring cast member in your own party. Each and every time you go out there. There's also another group of people I got to thank because I want to make sure that they understand to be on our board and be on our President's Club is a big, big deal here. And I want to give my President's Club, I want them to stand, and I want them to take a big, huge round of applause right now because they've done a great job. They have done a great job, and I want them to know this. And to be on one of our boards or one of our President's Club, what I talk about this. When my mom first started out this, and she had this one mission about going out there and educating women and going out there and empowering people to take ownership of their relationship and ownership of what it was that they were looking for. The company grew so much. I came on board with her, and she always had a board. And what we look at is, as board members, they're an extension of Patty. They're an extension of the belief of what we went out there, what she started back in 1993. And I can tell you right now, we have some amazing, amazing board members. Women that go out there each and every night that are holding team meetings, that are leading by example, that are going out there and not being selfish, they're being selfless. And that's a big thing. Please give a round to your big board. They are right back there. Board, stand up. They are rock stars, senior board, executive board, all of these women each and every day are striving to figure out how the best way it is to move this company forward. And I can tell you right now, when you walk in a room like this, you feel the energy, don't you? You feel that people want to see you succeed, that the people that are sitting to your right and left are going, gosh, I am so excited to be here today because I'm going to take something away from it and I'm going to apply it. The other people that I want to thank too that apply things every day is that you have the hardest working, most dedicated, loving, caring, committed, and ball-busting staff you will ever meet in your entire life. Because what they do every day is they go out and they make it good for you and for you and for each and every one of you that they work so hard. Because it can't just be Patty, it can't just be me, it can't just be the board, it can't be the President's Club, it's each and every one of them. So when you see that staff, you go up there, you hug them, you tell them that they're family, because each and every day they work their asses off for you. They're committed, baby. And I gotta say hi, and you guys can say hi too, because they're gonna be filming over you right now, to the thousands of people that are online watching this all around the world. Say hi to all of your sisters. Say hi to everybody that's out there. A lot of them wish they could be here. A lot of them are talking online. I wish I would have come. Your ass won't miss it next year. And that's the truth. And I can tell you right now, we have an all-star lineup. We have a lot of women that are going to be going to classes tomorrow, getting some education, but we have some great speakers that are going to be happening as well. What about Allison Mirazzi? She's going to be speaking. Allison's she talks about business and transforming through wellness and changing through success. And also, we got Fern Gerber, number 25 global when it comes to leadership. This woman is amazing. When you hear some of the things that she has to say, you're going to be flabbergasted. But she also has been featured on Oprah as well. We got a couple Oprah people, if you know what I mean, coming this week. We also have Matthew Kelly, Rhythm of Life, the Dream Manager. Some of the leaders got to see Matthew a little bit ago, and they got to go through that and listen to him. And Matthew speaks the truth. And some of you get to coach with Sarah Klein. Sarah Klein and Matt work really, really close in hand. And if you don't know Sarah Klein, you will, because Sarah Klein teaches some of the top consultants. She works with them on business coach, on performance, on getting the most that she could possibly get out of them. And we also have our squiggle, our circles, our triangles, and our squares. Connie Pedosa's coming back. She's going to teach you how to stand out from the crowd. She's going to teach you to understand a little bit more about yourself. So you're probably going, I already know myself. You'll learn more. And she's great. And if you've been to her class, you will go back and talk about it because you'll figure out a little bit more about how you operate. And we also have one other lady. You got to eat, you got to pray, and you got to love Elizabeth Gilbert. Now, big magic, all this stuff, and I remember when we told the board, they were like, it was like you would have thought Elvis was back in the building. I'm excited to hear her because she is a great, great speaker, and she also talks about things that you can apply into your world, into your life. And I can tell you right now, just listening to her and talking and doing some of the pre-con stuff with her, she's magical. And I hope that you do one thing. You're not going to retain everything that you learned this week. It's impossible. This week, it's about taking nuggets. It's about figuring out what nuggets that you can go and you can apply once you get home. That's the big thing. But these speakers are going to give you a lot of things that you want to try or do or whatever. I just want you to be thinking about it. That doesn't mean you throw everything out and you start brand new. It's the small changes. Remember what we talked about on the bus tour? We talked about this. A lot of people gain weight during the holidays and they blame it on 7 damn days. They're like, you know what? I gained a lot of from Christmas to New Year's. I gained a lot of weight. You ever hear people say that stuff? And you're like, no, your ass didn't. You gained it between New Year's and Christmas. It's the small things that we put out there. It's the small things that we do. Now, speaking of small, do you guys know, this is not a joke, that for all of us small people out there, it's Small Person Appreciation Day. So, if you're sitting next to a small person, hug them. We all need love. It's okay. It's okay. I was hugging on Patty a lot behind stage. Speaking of small, though, it's not a small feat when you earn an incentive here, Pure Romance. It's not a small feat when you go out there and you put the time and the grind in. And I'm going to show you some of these ladies that have earned their Cancun trip. Because they have went out there and they have busted their hump on party booking, on sponsoring, going out there. So when your name is called, please stand. They're going to roll them right now. Wow, that's fast. I'm telling you, we have had, it is amazing. How many people are excited about going on that trip? It is going to be something I will promise you that you will talk about because at Pure Romance, we don't do anything. Half, you know what I'm saying. Yes, and Cheryl, my clicker's not working, just so you know. All right, here's the other thing that I want to talk about too, is this. We've got another big thing that's coming up. Whoa. But Cancun, here we go. But we have another big thing that's getting ready to come. On the heels of this. Y'all, take it back to being normal here. The other thing that I want to make sure that you talk about too is we have some training that's getting ready to come up, and it's our in-market training that's going to start in April 19th. We're going to Indianapolis. We're going to Idaho Falls. And I'm coming to Montana. I told you we would be there. We have that. We also are coming to Charleston, South Carolina. And then we start our May bus tour run. We have the Own the Spotlight tour, which is going to be phenomenal. How many of you guys are registered and excited about going to the Own the Spotlight tour? It's going to be awesome. But there's also one other thing that we're going to be doing as well. And that's going to be, we are going to have the best and most awesome time in Cincinnati, Ohio, at National Training. Are you guys ready to have a little bit of fun? I know that you guys are going to be excited about doing this in August on the 6th. Oh, what was that? All right, I can tell you right now, it is going to be amazing. We are going to have a lot of fun at the National Training. Now, I will promise you, when you walk out of that event, you are going to want to know what's going to happen. You're going to want to be there. Don't be square on the 4th, because we're going to start registration at 9 a.m. We're going to have our classes that are going to start at 1. General session that night, and we're going to be out of that building, out of Cincinnati, at 2 p.m. on the 6th. It's going to be a fun pact, so don't forget to register. Right now, we have over 700 women that have been registered and are ready. Raise your hand if you're coming to National Training Cincinnati. Because in Cincinnati, you're going to learn to do this one other tactic. You're going to learn the best of the best when it comes to booking parties. When it comes to go out there sharing the opportunity, when it goes to going out there and how to lead by example. And right now, I want to bring up some people that really rocked our last booking blitz that we did, because we have another booking blitz that's coming up, people. In our booking blitz, I want to recognize some of these people that went out and did an unbelievable job going out there. So if your team is called, heck, if your team's not called, you want to cheer for these ladies because they've done a great job. And we had two things that we did during this booking blitz. One was sponsoring and the other one was booking parties. Our number three team that we went out there and did sponsoring, Pink Lady Nation, accepted an award, Jen Roy. Great job. Number two in sponsoring, Team Fierce, accepting the award, Mary Fleming. And our number one, the Diamond Divas, accepting the award, Dana Barish. They don't have to go far because they're going to be getting their pink trophies, but we're going to ship them to them because so many people were like, I had to carry it through the airport, and they thought that they were actually had a long night of just pouring alcohol on it. I said, no, no. But we also want to recognize our top three in booking parties during that time. Number three, Pink Lady Nation, Miss Jen Roy. And I can't get you out of my head. Number two in bookings, the Diamond Divas. I can imagine like us three, us four going, that'd be crazy. All right, and number one in bookings, Later Babies. Accepting the award, Mia Rivera. What? Give them a big round of applause. We're gonna pick, get a picture right. Look right at that camera right there. Great job. Give them one more big round. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. Awesome. I know they're going to get excited because we got our booking blitz. Our booking blitz is going to be April 5th through the 18th. We've got so many things that are going to be going on. We got live Ustreams that are going to be happening the entire time. And oh, by the way, during that event, we're going to give $25,000 away. Prizes, cash, trips, all kinds of different things because it is going to be awesome. And next year, we're going to have the top 10 teams that are going to recognize and walk away with their own pink cup. We're also going to have a little friendly competition. Now, the friendly competition is this. You know, you always hear that the people are a little bit different east of the Mississippi because that's the people from the west of the Mississippi talking about them. And people from the west of the Mississippi are different because the east of the Mississippi people talk about them too. We're going to have an east-west competition. It's friendly, but... Oh! Little chatter going on right now. Some teams are going to have some things to talk about. Can I tell you, though? It's all about having fun and supporting each other. You know... You know, I kind of started off tonight and I talked a little bit about how crazy and how much fun we've had here at Pure Romance over the last couple years. But 15 was a rock star year. Amazing. It was a record-breaking year. And throughout this event, you're going to see a couple different things. And the couple things that you're going to see throughout this event is you're going to hear and see 96 women that are running a million-dollar team. They're going to come up, 96 million-dollar teams. Over 80 women that are going to walk across the stage that have done $100,000 or more. You know, as I was sitting here watching my mom talk, and I've, you know, she always goes over that. She'll be the first one to tell you she doesn't like the public speaking thing. But her message is always consistent. I look at when she started this business. In 1983, she got into this industry. 1993, she starts this with 55 people, goes out there, and builds it. And I think about our 24-year journey that she's kind of had doing this. You know, I think about the first event that we ever had. It was on State Route 28 in Milford. And some of you guys know exactly where that's at. It was outside of this one little office building. And she started this and thought about how she was going to go out and give women an opportunity. And you fast forward 24 years, and there's been a lot of things that have happened in those 24 years. Look at us tonight. We're in this beautiful hotel, in this beautiful ballroom, and we have worked so hard, and each and every one of us have put a brick into this company. Each one of us have went out there and busted our butts to get this company to where it goes, because one woman started out with a dream, one woman started out with a mission. But the one thing that we have all done, and the one thing that this company has done, is defy the odds. You know how some, when Patty said, some people call her lucky, fortunate, being in the right place at the right time? She was none of those. She worked really hard. As some of you are working in your business, you're going to have to understand, you're going to have to defy the odds. I've seen so many women that have went out and started in this business that have had to do just that. Because the one thing that we all got to keep in mind is that 95% of businesses fail in the first 5 years. In the first 5 years, people going out there and running it is the times that they have to have the blinders on. They have to be extremely focused. They got to know exactly where they're going, what they're heading to. Because I can tell you right now, in business, it is tough. But if you're not focused and not committed, that's where you can get caught up. But here's the thing. You take a look around this room. I mean, really take a look around this room. There's some very, very successful people. There's success every which way I turn around. You can't walk down the hallway without having a story. And here's the thing. Success is only determined by the one person. It is not determined by anybody else except you. It's not determined by Inspire. It's determined by the person that you are. What do you deem as successful? You take Pure Romance. Over the last 10 years, this company has grown on average 14% a year. 14% a year. Each year, double-digit growth. Now, the one thing I will tell you is that's something to be really, really proud of. That's something to be excited about. And the one thing that I tell people all the time is that is awesome when you think about that. I've been doing this for 16 years. You know how many companies I've seen come and go? You know how many companies I've seen that have 1,000% increase or 500% increase, and I watch them where they're at next year, the year after that? Ladies, I will tell you, I would rather have 100 years of 10% growth than 1 year of 1,000% growth. And the one thing I know to be true is in my 24 years, I've never asked Facebook for advice. It's kind of like if you go to Facebook, it's kind of like having an eight ball. Is my business going to be good? Outlook not so good. Am I going to make a lot of money this year? Got to get back to you later. If you look at this and you think about this, in business, you got to keep your blinders on, and you got to keep completely focused. When you look at this behind me, you're going to see a lot of different words are going to pop up. You're going to see a lot of things that are going to happen. When you look at this is a lot of things that people ask, how have you been successful? And a lot of the ways in which we've been successful are right behind me. You know, you think about this. A lot of people, when they go out there and they're talking about this, a lot of people had to say yes in the beginning. They had to say, yes, I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to go out, and I'm going to say yes to somebody that's going to sign me up. You all had to say yes to something, didn't you? You had to say yes to sign up PRCA or PRCF or whatever the hell we call it now. You had to go out there. You had to sign up online. Somebody had to get you and talk you about this business. And each one of you said yes. Not only did somebody say yes, but when you said yes, you had to have the willingness. The willingness to go out there and say, yes, I'm going to go out there and I'm going to rock out this business. The willingness to want to say, I will go out there and I will put the time and the effort in. All of those things are important. Because of Pure Romance, we understand one thing. I see so many people hashtag this. I see so many people put their do life different, buying a house, doing all the things that they do. And they talk about this one piece. thinking about doing life different. Because you know what? Most of you understand, because you've been educated, you've went through the program, you understand this, that nobody wants to do things like everybody else, especially here at Pure Romance, because you understand that most people don't start savings accounts until they're over 35. The average person in America has less than $500. You already know that you need $109,500 put away so you can survive, not thrive, but survive. You know that the average person in America right now is in debt $13,000. You don't want to be like everybody else. You chose this business because you said, I will be different. I will do things completely different. I am not a person that is not knowing what's going on in this world today. Because you've taken all of which could have been taglines at companies. All of those could have been taglines, slogans, brands, whatever, but not here. And that starts with making sure that the leaders and the people in the room, they are living the lives that they're talking about. They're doing things completely different. But it starts out with making sure that you have the willingness to take a step and take a chance. You got to be willing to take the naysayers. You got to be willing to take a chance to go out there and do something completely different. Like some of these women that are behind me, when you look at them on the screen, these women went out there and they said, you know what, I'm going to go take a chance in my business. I don't know where this whole thing is going to go. I signed a PRCA because this lady was really good at a party, and I thought she was funny, and I had one too many glasses of wine. No, I'm kidding. And you know what? They did it. But they were willing to take that chance, that willing to step out of that box and do something completely outside of most of their comfort zones. Because I know when you guys graduated high school or college, nobody said, gosh, I can't wait to get my degree in vibrators. Now, some of you might have, so if I did step on toes, I'm sorry. But here's the thing. You've broken up those piggy banks. You've done what it takes. You're willing to come here to Orlando. You're willing to take a chance and say, you know what? I want to do something for myself. And each one of you are in Orlando right now in a seat to take your business to another level. And if you didn't get an email, I'm going to send you another one. I said, how many damn emails do we send about World Conference? You'll get a couple more by the time you get out of here, don't worry. But here's the thing, you're gonna be here for a couple different reasons, and if you think about it, I don't care what you're thinking right now. You might be the woman that's here, and she might say, you know what, Chris, I worked really hard in 2015. I'm gonna go to classes, I'm gonna go to conferences, I'm gonna enjoy all these parties that we have, but the one thing I'm gonna do too is this. I'm going to spend some time with my family. I'm going to turn this into a family trip. I'm going to go out there and I'm going to enjoy Epcot and Disney and SeaWorld and all of these other places, because you know what? At the end of the day, that's what I got into this for. Some of you might be sitting in that room and you're right here and you're like, gosh, I just took my last $200, which I did talk to somebody today. She's like, you know what? I packed peanut butter. I packed bread. I packed chips. And you know what it is? But I took my $200 and I invested in the one thing that I haven't invested in. And she said, I listened to what you said and I got to start feeling like I deserve it. And I took my $200 and I feel like I deserve to be here with these women so I could take my business to another level. You gotta take the time that if you're a brand new consultant, that you're gonna be here and you're gonna soak up every bit of information that you possibly can. You're gonna go meet as many people as you possibly can to get that one nugget that you can implement into your business. Or hey, you're a brand new leader and you got three people on your team. And you're sitting there going, I'm gonna get and talk to every leadership person I can find, because I invested not just to be here to party, not just to be here to go and watch the award show, but I invest it because this is what I want to put into my future for my family. Or you might be here because you want to reconnect with some of your sister consultants around the country. You might be sitting here saying, you know what, we miss each other. Yes, we see each other on Facebook. Yes, we see each other on Pinterest. Yes, we see each other on Instagram. But it's not the same, is it? It's not the same when you get that big hug or that big, you know, just, I'm so excited to see you. I'll tell you right now, that group in the back, you know what I'm talking about, don't you? It's like seeing and being at a family reunion. Or you might look at this picture and sit right now at the end of this event, and you know what you might say when you're done? You might go, I will never, ever, 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 ever come to an event that my B-U-T-T-Y does not walk across this stage. Booty, butt, whatever you want to talk about. At the end of the day, you got to think about this. Three questions I wake up every morning and ask myself. Three questions. Question number one is this. You think about when you're sitting at your laptop and this conference is over, you're going to have the same three questions that I ask myself all the time. Because what's going to happen, the shine, the sparkle, the excitement, it's going to fade off because you're going to have to be back in reality. And these questions are going to come up in your mind. Question number one is going to come up and it's going to be this. Can I do it? Can I go out there and do this? Can I go out there and really get what I've got to get out of this business? Because here's the thing, what I find in this business, they're success seekers. They're the ones that come into every meeting. They're the ones that are sitting there going, you know what? I want to take my business to a whole new level. I want to go out there and I want to get so immersed in every freaking thing that I can get my hands on. They are so excited. They're like, I will succeed at every cost. Give me any business book, any way to go out and book a party. But you know what I find more? It's failure avoiders. People want to go out and succeed, and they talk about it, but more people are scared of failing than they are succeeding. You got to understand, in this business and in life, stuff is going to happen, man. Stuff is going to come, and it's going to get in your way. And you've got to understand, you cannot be controlled by understanding and knowing that there are going to be consequences in your business. There are going to be things that are happening. Most of us don't understand this. We are so controlled by consequences. We are so afraid that if we fail or we do something wrong, that everybody around us is going to think we're a failure. No, I say fail fast, fail often, fail as much as you can, because I got my MBA in failing. Because you know what failure leads to? Failure is the corner. It is right around the corner to success, because you know what I'll tell you? There's more people that play it safe in this world than take damn chances. And I can tell you that because I sit around and I talk to people, business owners, and the ones that decide that they are going to go out there and they're going to take these chances and take these risks are the ones that I see that propel themselves. But most of them are so afraid of failing because the consequences of failing are so much on their soul and their mind. You got to tell yourself it's okay to fail. Because I can tell you this. Society is a little bit backwards. Isn't it crazy that society tells us if we're beautiful or successful? Society makes the determination if we're beautiful or if we're successful. And what I mean by that is this. What if you were on an island and you never met anybody before? Never met anybody. And you thought, gosh, you know what? I'm a hot mama. Or I'm successful as heck about getting those bananas off that damn tree. But it's so funny in this world today that we let all of these outside people control how we feel. And that is a shame, because that's absolutely a problem. And that's why every day you got to understand, you got to not only reassure yourselves that you're successful and that you're beautiful and that you're fun, but if you're not doing it for yourself, Who's instilling those values to your children? Who's instilling those values to them? So they grow up and they understand that they could be their own person in their own skin. Because the one thing we cannot do in life is we cannot compare somebody's chapter 1 to somebody's chapter 20. Can I do it? That's the question. What if I fail? I always say fail. It's okay to fail. Fail often, fail good. But here's the thing. Most people, when they think of failure, they think of these words right here, right? They think of, oh my gosh, I'm a loser, I'm wrong, something's gonna happen. And it's so funny, the other day I'm sitting in bed and we're here in Orlando and we're trying to get ready for Easter with our kids. That was fun. So Jessica turns on Joel Osteen, which I love me some Joel. You guys ever watch Joel Osteen? And so this whole thing comes on about, you know, be blessed by your enemies. Your enemies are your friends. It's okay to have enemies. I love that dude. He makes me laugh. And I'm sitting there and I'm watching him talk. And this one thing came up. And he started talking about, you know, if there was no Goliath, there would be no David. And he started talking about people are put in your path to help promote you. The people that hate sometimes are the people that help you get to your next level. And the one thing that I took from this whole thing is he said, in the most pressure times is where we can go the furthest. When we have the most amount of pressure on us, we perform the greatest. And he's sitting there saying, you know, have you ever washed your car before? And you got that hose. And you got that hose out. And you go ahead and you want to get spray that other side of the thing, and you don't have that nozzle on there. You know what you do. You go ahead and you put that thumb right in that hose. And you know what that water does? It doesn't stop and just drop underneath you. It squirts, and it propels, and it goes further than you think it can because it's under so much pressure that that water shoots and goes further than you think it could go. And that's what our lives are. The more pressure that we have, the further that we can go. But we just don't know it. That's when we find the confidence. That's where we find that our true self is in those pressure cooker times. You're going to ask yourself this week, do you have what it takes? You're going to see people that are going to be coaching in these rooms, doing parties in these rooms. And you're going to ask yourself, can I do what she does? Can I go out there and do what she does? Am I doing all the right things? Am I doing the proper hostess coaching? Am I showing the right products? Am I talking the same way she's talking? But the one thing it comes down to, do I have enough confidence to do this? Confidence is developed. Confidence is done over consistent time of doing something. But the one thing that you might know and you need to take away from this week is this. You might not throw the best party. You might not do everything the right way. But you got to understand is that you have to know one thing to be true. That the more confident that you walk into somebody's home, the more confident that you go up there and you greet somebody, the more confident that you go out there and do it. Can I tell you, people want to be around confident people. Not cocky, confident. Because in this business, our attitude, how we carry ourselves, is the most important thing. You can go out there and not have the best party, not have the best demo, not have the best, you know, way to go out and sponsor somebody. But can I tell you something? When I come up and I talk to some of you and I see you and I see the way that you smile and I see the way that you talk, that's what it's about, man. You guys have this attitude that nothing's going to get in your way. Because what the deal is this. Because of Pure Romance, yeah, we do life different. And we do have great leaders. And we constantly make sure that the message of the founder is consistent throughout everything because it's the attitude. Just like these women, they got badass attitudes. They go out there each and every day with their teams and they're moving and they're talking to them. And they understand that they got to go out there and do this. And the second question that always comes up is this. I ask, will you do it? Chris, can you do it? Hell, I've been asking myself that question. I've been asking that question since I've been 25. every day. Been asked the same question, will you do it? Because there's days that you're going to get up and you got to remember one thing. What are you playing for in this business? Do you remember that each and every day that you get up here, that you have the ability to go out there, and what are you doing in this business to help you get to your goals? When you look at the words that come up and you think about this, that's when I come and I start talking about living life by design. Live life by design is not just a slogan. At Pure Romance, can I tell you, I know there are stories back there. Each one of them decided that they were going to write their own chapter, because there's been hundreds of thousands of women that have joined this organization. Living life by design is that they remember each and every day, why are they doing this business? That's what it really means. And for some of you, when I sit down and talk to you, it's 20 reasons. There's 20 reasons why you're doing this. And you list them all off. Those 20 reasons are 10 fingers and 10 toes. A lot of you are doing this for your children. A lot of you are doing this because you're going out there, and you might be a woman that has went out there and tried to adopt a child and had a bunch of failed attempts, but you know what? Stayed committed because she was able to go out there and take her Pure Romance business and decide when she went to work. Or a lobbyist that decided, you know what? I wasn't sure I was ever going to have kids, but then had kids, but had the flexibility to make the decision, to make the choice on what she wanted to do. Because here's the thing, I see you guys post your stuff on your Facebook pages. Yeah, you do take a lot of selfies of yourself, and it's okay. But a lot of you take a lot of pictures of your kids because you understand, you know this to be true, that it's not about shipping just anything out. It's not just shipping out an order to somebody. It's not that you understand the things that we talk about here. It's about going out there and taking care of your clients. We don't just ship out orders. We ship out ballerina shoes, basketball shoes, cleats. That's what we do here. Because we understand that it's your bill money to take care of your family. That's what this thing is about. Because you got some people that care. They care about where you're going. You got mothers that don't want to miss a time and watch their kids grow. You have to ask yourself when you get done, and each and every day, what your life, live life by design is. What's your why? What's your next thing that you're going to be able to go out there? And how are you going to go out there and not only figure out what's your why, but how will you live life different? Are you going to do the same activities that you've been doing and not getting the results that you want? No, because you're smarter than that. You understand that at Pure Romance, it's about the experiences that we were able to talk to. I was able to meet with a group of women when we went to Atlanta, and we had some awesome experiences. We were able to talk and have such good conversation. We've been able to do so many experiences that you guys have been able to do at Reds games, going out and doing nights on the town with your teams. How many of you cherish those times that you get to spend with them? Or you get to go around the world and travel here at Pure Romance. I've got to see so many women go to Italy. They go to South Africa. They go to Australia. They go to the Caribbean. They get to see this world in the eyes of being a Pure Romance consultant. And the other thing is this, they get to enjoy life. I don't think I could ever put you guys in a bad situation. Because ultimately, there's a bunch of women in this room that enjoy each other's company and enjoy seeing each other succeed. And there's nothing like going on a trip with some of you and seeing that camaraderie and that sisterhood that goes there. Don't go through life not creating memories. It's so short and it's so fast. Every day you wake up is a memory that is lost or gone, and you have to understand this. You have to create these. You got to make these moments. When you're tired, don't sleep. When you're hungry, keep moving forward. When you want to quit, don't. Do everything that nobody else will do. Do everything that nobody else will do. Because if you want to be successful in this world, you got to understand this. At Pure Romance, that's what we do. We are not normal. On multiple levels. But I can tell you right now, you do not want to get in the middle of this pink army. I will tell you that, because this pink army is somebody I would not want to screw with on any day of the week. You're what you do, not what you say you'll do. You're what you do, baby. If you're going to go out there, you got to do it. Don't talk about it. Don't make motions about it. You just got to do it. Don't sit there and say, hey, I need somebody to hold me accountable. Because the only person that's going to hold you accountable is who? The person you look at the mirror each and every day. That's the person that's going to go out there. And you got to make sure that you have consistent goals. Where are you going to go? What do you want to do with your life? You got to have yourself and hold yourself accountable. Because ultimately, you can't put your pleasure and pain in somebody else's hands. You have to own that. You have to do the things that nobody else wants to do. The only thing standing behind you and the truth is the BS things that you tell yourself. And you got to understand that you have to get up every morning and say you could do this. And I know it's hard because every morning you sit back and some of you grab that pillow and want to scream in that damn pillow and sit there and go, gosh, I don't want to get up. I don't want to take on this day. But that's bullshit because you can and you should. And the third and final thing that I'll tell you is this. You're going to ask yourself, is it worth it? I can tell you right now, is it worth it? Hell yeah, it's worth it. You know how many lives you've seen that have changed? Because what they understand is this, the hard work is the future payoff. The hard work that these women go out there and do and walk across stage and do the stuff that they do, the hard work is just this. The hard work is the future payoff. Laziness, though, pays off right damn now. And you have to understand, when you see some of these women that went out there and you see some of the override checks, or you see some of the things that they've been able to go out there and do for their teams and buy some of the things that they've been able to buy, or the homes, or the mobile homes, or the vans that they've been able to buy, they've been able to go out there and do so much with this business. And you guys know what I'm talking about right there. And I'm going to ask you, board, Presence Club, is it worth it? It's absolutely worth it, but you gotta hustle, don't you? You gotta make sure that when you're going out there, that you are hustling every day. And I say the speed of the team is the speed of the leader. And if you don't have a team, then you know what? Go build one. Because ultimately, you set the pace of where you wanna go. Nobody gets in your way except you. You set that pace because, can I tell you something? You're the only one. And not everyone will keep up with you, by the way. You're gonna ask, where's the next me? But I can tell you right now, there isn't. There's only one of you. And be lucky. Be lucky. But surround yourself with successful people. If you got the people that are in your life that want to bitch about stuff, use Facebook as their damn therapist, get away from their ass. Get with doers. Get people that want to do. Get people that want to achieve things. Get people that think differently. People that want to trailblaze different paths, different things, because that's what this business is all about. Never take advice from somebody's ass that quits. You know? It's like this, take my advice, I'm not using it. Take my advice, I'm not using it, right? That's life, baby. And at Pure Romance, the one thing that you get back to, and the truth of this whole thing is this. When we wake up, and we do this business, like I said before, it is nothing more than a vehicle that each one of us got those keys when we first signed up. And we got those keys to go out there and drive this vehicle, drive it as far as we want to go, take this to the next level, take this and be able to do as much as we possibly can because we are given the opportunity to go out there and drive this. You need to turn those three questions into three things you're going to tell yourself. Yes, you can do this. Yes, you will do this. And yes, it's damn worth it because I can tell you right now, here at Pure Romance, each and every one of you are worth it. And each and every one of you that go out there in homes each and every night, and the women that are watching on Ustream, and the women that go out there and do what they do when they go out there and live the mission that Patty started, which is empowering women. which is educating women and doing it in a fun, entertaining women. I applaud you. I respect you. I love you. Let's talk about some products.